Mama on Love Island and that, bro. Yeah. Love Talking Island about, crazy, what's the guy's name again?
Which one?
The Danny guy.
Oh, well, Danny yeah, something. Yeah, Danny Bibby.
Danny Webby.
Oh, bro, yeah, I saw that. I saw that still.
My name
is so funny.
When I saw that, I'm like, what? I'm literally thinking, what's going on? I'm being pranked.
I know where we're going with this, yeah. But that's a straight no. Bro. You don't do that, bro.
Yeah,
bro.
You can't, yeah. Like,
yo, fam, like, you know what? Let's talk about it, though. Can your white friends use the N-word on you? Like, yo, like, you know, because this conversation has been going on for time, innit? Yeah? Yeah. Where people say, yo, but that's my boy, like, we grew up together, I know this and this and this. How do you feel about some people letting their white friends use the N-word on them?
If they're letting their friends use the N-word, that's on them, do you see what I mean? But me, personally, I'm not gonna let it run, do you know what I mean? And the thing is, it's a thing of, you have to understand that at the end of the day, they need to understand why not to use it. You know what I mean? Mm. Even if they hear it on a regular basis.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Like, for example, I can't remember what video it was, but there was, I think it was a Kendrick Lamar situation.
Oh, right, when he put the fan on.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I saw that.
You
see
what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so some
that's
people,
different, though. But
it's
like,
different, yeah. But at the same time, people are aware. Or white people, some white people are aware, knowing they shouldn't say it.
What I'm saying.
But this is the thing. It's like, as far as Danny Bibby is concerned,
my guy's name
Danny Bibby.
Nuts.
Yeah.
It's like,
my guy's name is nuts.
The funny thing about it is the fact of, obviously it was on social media, right?
Yeah.
And he said it towards a white guy, not a black guy.
Mm, yeah.
So
that shit was crazy.
That was one that's unexpected. But then if you look at his other situation where, you know, there's other mad situations that he's been through. And then I think, I don't know, someone was trying to break down these tattoos. He's got like 13 and that represents Aryans and all that stuff there. Like,
oh, is it?
I'm
is
thinking,
them man?
I'm like, this is mad. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, Love Island should kick
thing,
him
man.
Off.
I'll tell you one thing, yeah. You don't mess about with black Twitter, bro, because they will find any sort of rap shit you've got.
Yeah.
Listen, and bring it on.
By the time he came up.
Twitter in general, bro.
By the time he came up, his thing came up. Bang, I swear, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Of course.
Get
of
him
course.
Off the program.
Of
literally.
Course.
Don't mess
of
about
course.
The black Twitter, bro. I'll tell you that now.
Of course, 100%.
But me personally, though, I think, and I know this is going to sound crazy, but if I've got my boy who's white and this is my boy, I don't think I have a problem with people telling me, yo, my nigga, whatever. I don't personally think I have a problem with it.
Is it? Why though?
What could he do in the presence of other people?
When he presents other people, then obviously he needs to understand that people might find offense to it. Like, you know.
All right, but so if it's on social media, right, and he makes it,
on social media,
he says my, and he said my nigga.
Yeah. No, on social media, no. Because obviously you're people
even
are
that,
watching. Yeah.
Even that sounds and looks mad. Because it's like, even though you understand where it is, it's like other people won't understand. You see what I mean? It's like, because obviously we know what the
racial connotation to
But then obviously what's mad is, it's such a conflicting situation because I can understand from, this is going to sound mad controversial, but I can understand why some white people would want to say it. You see what I mean?
Because why do you think they want to say it?
One is because obviously if you're hearing it regularly in rap music and all that stuff there, and they're using it in the term of endearment, not the other one.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? So obviously you got the, cause I think even Tupac said it.
He said that
the other one is never ignorant, getting goals accomplished.
Yeah.
So it's like, I'm thinking, I can understand from that perspective, but I genuinely think at the same time, how about I not say it?
Yeah.
You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, even though I may say it now and again, but that's just like, what do you call it? Like reflex.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's like, sooner or later, you know, I can improve on my vocabulary and stuff like
Hold on. So are you trying to say that, I don't know if I heard it right, that black people should not say it too?
Yeah. The reason why I'm saying that is because it's just...
Is it?
Yes.
Because it's...
Why though? I disagree.
That racial connotation, man. That's like, listen, man. That's all our ancestors and everything that been through slavery and know what that word means. You know what I mean? Like, in the presence of my black friends as well, I never ever say, yo, what's up? I don't say it. I get the connotation when you're listening to rap music and you're hearing white people say, I haven't got no problem. Because obviously they're reciting lyrics. They're reciting lyrics. But if someone comes up to me and goes, yo, I don't use that. I don't call my brethren up and go, yo, what you saying? It should be banned. It should be banned for everyone, man.
But this is the thing though, right? I look at it from this perspective, right? Yeah. Because you hear women now use the B word, right?
Yeah.
But then this is the thing. The B word was sort of made sort of like to throw insult at them, right? They'd be like, oh, that's a B, da 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 da. Now they took the word, right? And empowered it, right? And now they're using it. Mm. So I look at the N-word like that. Just because now you're not allowed to use it, right? That was what you were calling us, right? As insults or whatever. Now we took the word from you, right? And now we've used it as a term of endearment for us. Now, because you know you're not allowed to use it, you're now saying, "Raw, okay, if we're not allowed to use it, why not? We just scrap the word now, like no one should use it anymore." Nah, you are not allowed to use it. You get what I'm saying?
No, but see, this is the problem. I feel like, because genuinely, unfortunately, at this present moment, we don't have that much real power. Because think about it, with the Jewish people, right?
Yeah.
Like basically, they have the power. So if anyone says anything that they feel is anti-Semitic, you're out of it. Mm. Do you see what I mean? Mm. So if we had the same level of power, then
it's not slow. I want to come back on you on that.
Yeah.
So you see, with the word anti-Semitic, okay, is that if we say something that, if we say so, Jewish people own majority of the, in like how Wiley said it, is that, which is, I'm not going to disclaimer, I think it's true.
Like I people, know it's true. Definitely.
I mean, so is that anti-Semitic?
It's not anti-Semitic, but this is the problem. So because they got the power, they're able to control and manipulate the situation to their advantage. So if we had that power, do you see what I mean? Then we can literally control the situation and be like, you can't say that. Do you see what I mean? Because think about it. I swear, I can't remember who it was, but there was another rapper. I think he's from North London, but like he is a white rapper, but he said something.
He said something. Was he not gaslighting? I think it was like the golden generation where he said like black women are ugly or something. And he started speaking.
Yoruba.
Sick. And then like said black Twitter finds everything, bro. Found him. Like hold on a second. Like digged up, bro. You're calling black women ugly, this like that. And now how are you gonna say I got you're gonna speak Yoruba kind of thing? And then I think he went on ZZ show, and he was apologetic for it, but it's like at that time I'm like, well, yeah, you know what I mean? Like it's just
wrong. But this is what I'm saying. But now he's still able to still literally make music and all that stuff there. If it was like I'm saying with the whole like Wiley situation, you know what I mean? He's like as much as he's still about the way he can be about because he, you know what I mean? Like they still tried to get him out of it, you know what I mean? But he found a way. For example, I can't remember what song it was. I think it was, from They Don't Care About Us. Mm. Like, Michael Jackson said even though it wasn't in a negative way, they still
wanted to get him out of here. Yeah,
they tried to get him out of it with that. Yeah. So this is what I mean about power. It's like, they're able to try and control that situation. So once we have that power, then we can say, oh, white people can't say that, but we can or whatever. Do you know what I mean?
I'm going to go back and I agree with you on that, you know, because obviously I'm a Spurs fan and the word, I don't say it, but the word Yid is, to a Jewish person, is not actually deemed as an anti-Semitic term.
Right.
Yeah, but overall, you use footballing terms like a lot of Chelsea fans and a lot of West Ham fans use that word and then we're like, hold on, it's, that's the way they say it is anti-Semitic.
Yeah.
But like, if you go to a Jewish person and go, you don't go up to them and go, yo, what are you saying, my yid? Like, that's, you don't say that. But to them, it's not an actual, like, it's a deformed word of like Yiddish or something like that. Someone explained it to me and it's not deemed as anti-Semitic. So there's where you're coming from with the words of anti-Semitism is that you can say certain things and like say like I would say like Jewish people own that majority of knowledge. But that's,
they don't like it when people
say
it.
They don't like that. And that's anti-Semitic. And I'm like, hold on, but if I
we cannot give you guys compliments. So
yeah. You know what I mean?
But so I think it's the tone. Some people say it, and I get when people say it, but some people say it in the sense of, okay, I'm saying it for you to now hate them because they own all that shit.
Mm. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. But the thing is, I don't think it's necessarily in that situation with their tonality. I think because what it is a thing of the, some people may say it with that tonality, but I feel like it's never with the intention that for other people to hate them. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just letting them know that this is the situation. Yeah, so you have to understand what it is. Yeah, you know what I mean?
For example, wasn't another song, I think it was Jay-Z's song in not 444. I think it was probably 444 when he was talking about
Fair Play.
The O.J. Simpson song.
So he later came out to apologize for what he said about the Jews, right?
Yeah.
Because he said it on that song. But if you actually listen to the song, right, he was basically saying, yo, if you want to be successful, look at the way these guys did that's the way you're going to be successful.
100.
Right? Mm. But they don't like it when you say that, which I cannot get because I heard someone trying to explain it. That they're saying that it's dangerous when people say that because that was how, Hitler, that was how he started the whole genocide thing happened, right? So he started with, yo, bro, like, how can we allow these guys own everything? These guys do this and this and this, right?
Yeah.
And now when the war was sort of coming up, a lot of people were now looking like, yo, you guys own this and this and this and this, but you guys are not gonna fight with us or whatever the case is. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. So that was how it started, and then obviously we now know the rest. Now I'm not sure but that was sort of like the history that I heard, right? So I think that's where they are kind of a little bit delicate when it comes to that.
Okay, now it makes sense.
When people say that, like, yo, you see, they own this and this and this, right? A lot of people are now looking, raw, they own this. Mm. And that compliment, or what is deemed as compliment, might somehow switch to something else.
Yeah, it might trigger people.
Might now switch to something else. So that's for a reason why. But like you said, they have the power to shut everything down, to be like, nah.
But then this is the thing, like, even if some say, oh yeah, it is, Jewish or whatever, we have to understand that we don't know who really owns everything, but there is a particular, they do have a particular structure in place that could help in their situation. The same thing with the alphabet community. I say it that way. No offense. No, it's just the fact of there's so many letters to go through.
You're right.
Your point with that,
like, they, if you say something, they come for you. Kevin Hart and so many other situations. Yeah. So it's a thing of, again, if we have that power, or when we do have that power, I want to speak that into existence, when we do have that power,
Do you think whoever have that power, though? 100%.
We're the chosen people.
Amen.
Amen. But then at the same time,
it's a fact of understanding our true roots.
Yeah, but then the thing is, we are too divided, though.
No, that's what I'm saying. We're too divided, but that's because of the way things have been set up. Do you see what I mean? Mm. Like, more people, like, if you think about it, like, with each generation, there's like a revolution with each generation. Mm. So there's always another breakthrough. Mm-hmm. Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah. So I feel like eventually, do you know what I mean? Things will happen. Like, because I've been talking about this for years. I'm like, we need to actually, we can coexist, but we need to have our own thing. Like, pre-colonialism, we had our own thing. We were doing our thing.
Yeah.
Yes, there was tribalism now and again, but at the same time, we still had our own empires. We were doing our thing.
100%. You see what I mean?
So even like after, I don't want to say after colonialism, because it's kind of a techie one, but like basically like around the 1800s, especially in America, I'm not too sure about in the UK, but they had the Black Wall Street.
They had
that in Tulsa.
Yeah.
But then they also had something else in New York as well. I forgot what the name, it was basically in Central Park, basically.
Yeah.
Like literally, and then for some reason that one just went different situation. Yeah. And then there was another, I think even Chicago as well. Do you see what I mean? Like, so we had our own thing, we're doing our thing. Yeah. But then the moment, you know, it's a thing of, all right, they come in with their racism and all that stuff there, then trying to separate, but come together, because it's like you want to be equal.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong with wanting to be equal, but you have to understand your place in society. Like a lion, like look at how many different cats there are. There's different cats, but a lion knows that it's a lion.
100%.
A tiger knows it's a tiger.
100%.
You see what I mean? A panther knows it's a panther, but they're all cats.
See, at the end of the day, right, this is the reason why a lot of people, I always tell people, why do you think they use the term race? We are on a race, right? White people, black people, Chinese people, this and this and this. It's a race in life, right? The finished goal is this, right? And I think right now, us as black people, we are all the way behind, right? Yes, some of it is slavery, cool, you know, and other kind of things, you know, but I also think, which I believe is probably the traumatic experience which have sort of trickled down through the generations in that, you know?
I agree, because
because you got to look at it right now, is that, look at the whole thing with like Black Lives Matter and everything now as well. We're doing more in terms of, especially that I know, is that we're buying into our own things. We've got Black Pound Day and everything, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Each month, like, obviously we need to be buying more into Black-owned businesses and everything.
Yeah.
I watched a documentary on Netflix with Killer Mike. I don't know if you lot have seen
it. Yeah. Oh, I still haven't seen it.
Yeah, like, we're talking about the Jewish community, how the money circulates for a week in the Jewish community. When it comes to Black communities, like, less than, an hour. That's how money, like, you know what I mean? We got to make sure that we set, like, and that's what it is in terms of black people as well.
That is the essence of Chinatown. That's the reason why Chinatown is in every major cities around the world.
That's true.
And when you go in there, all Chinese from A to Z. You know what I'm saying? So the money circulates.
But see, this is the thing. I think, as much as the money does circulate, I genuinely think we need our own monetary system. Because money obviously holds power, right?
Yeah.
But at the same time, if you think about within the, like, you know, African country with Independence Day and even Caribbean country with Independence Day, the same people that own the central banks.
Yeah.
It's the same people colonized them.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? And then they're loaning out the money, so now they're in debt. And I'm like,
right, this doesn't even make sense.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So it's just 100% another level of slavery.
Yeah, but, of course.
I think Kwame Nkrumah called it neocolonialism. So he knew that was coming, but I feel like this is what I mean. We just literally need our own everything.